تبارك الله كان زينة
والله وين الفترة كانت طويلة
من درا اللي تلقى زوار في المانيا باش
خلينا نركب لها المترو
تقد تعاون ولد خويا يجبر فيزا وراه هو لك لا اينشتاين الصغير كيفك انت ان شاء الله
حتى جيبه الصبح
والله ان شاء الله
ما نهنا ما هوش كم من مرة الله ينعل عليك نفس الكلام محفوظ ما عندي عنه أخبار ما ظهر لي قاع عن بالنادي نفسه يعرف هو منيح
شوف بعد تفجيرات نيويورك الناس عادوا لله يتهبزوا وكل حد يطير علي والخلطة يختيروك تجابر معاهم ويسولوك سمعت
اسمح لي صنبدل لا يشكوا لي امير خليجي
شيشتا تلو
بصايرتي
اعطيني تلفون اقصى اوكي
تركي وطافي الهج لا نقولها
انا كل لهم انا عندي عمل لو كان حكميني ما يخلوني نطلبهم بوتي تخافيهم انت
يمي حكميني شوي من الطعام
Morning, Diego.
Actually testify live at the hearing versus, for example, being subpoenaed by deposition testimony. In terms of the briefing schedule, we're just annotating.
Copy the case file.
We've proposed an exchange exhibit by the end of the month.
There are you sitting in? You're going to join the case? We'd be lucky to have you.
The plaintiff's been all over the news this morning.
Yeah, we expected that. He's not rattled. The airlines want to make it a PR campaign, but we'll beat them in court.
I see.
You're too quick. I was hoping to buy you lunch.
Go on, get in line. I recommend the asada.
Nah. So, how's Bill?
Separated.
Oh, sorry.
So was he. What can I do for you?
Last week in Paris, a lawyer from Mauritania approached my firm.
Mauritania?
Northwest Africa. The lawyer represents a family over there. In November 2001, the son was taken for questioning by Mauritanian police. He disappeared for 3 years. They don't know if he's dead, in prison, they don't know, no one knows. And then, a few weeks ago, Der Spiegel writes a story saying that he's detained in Guantanamo Bay. They say he's one of the organizers of 9/11.
Is he?
I don't know. I haven't spoken with him. Guantanamo will not even confirm that he's there. I don't have a security clearance.
Firm won't take a Gitmo case.
Since when do you care about what the firm thinks? And you still have your clearance from your NSA suit, no? Come on. One phone call. Just see if he's there.
Prisoner. What's his name? Slahi. S-L-A-H-I. First name, Mohamedou. No, not Mohamed. Mohamedou. Check the logs. Well, he's not there, or you don't know whether he's not there. All right, I'll hold.
Quarantine. Airlines.
Oh, yeah, it's okay. Well, but it's your facility, so how do you not know who you're holding? Well, he's not there. What does that mean? I mean, he's not Schrodinger's cat. He's either there or he's not there.
You want to represent the head recruiter for 9/11?
Alleged. And no, I'm defending habeas corpus, which Bush and Rumsfeld are dismantling gleefully as we speak.
Nancy, we'd all love a puppet this administration, but there's more to consider. People want to see these guys burn.
Including plenty of prospective clients.
The U.S. government is holding upwards of 700 prisoners at Guantanamo. Like, we don't know who they are. We don't know what they're charged with. Since when did we start locking people up without a trial in this country?
I don't want you spinning your wheels on this.
David, we agreed that we could pick our own pro bono fights. No interference. I like the look of this fight. I'm only coming to you as a courtesy.
Okay. What do you need?
Just me for now, and a translator with security clearance. The prisoner speaks Arabic, French, and German.
Sounds expensive.
Hey, Terry, you speak French, right?
Yeah, I'm on the Goranson case. Airlines.
Yeah, I've got no legs.
It's a bit harsh.
I looked at it. You got the wrong plaintiff. No jury's gonna get past that.
Yeah.
Terry?
Yes, sure. I mean, who doesn't want a free trip to Cuba, right?
Grab coffee?
I could take one intravenous.
Sure.
Hey, Stu!
Oh, I'll catch up with you all with you. Sir, I didn't see your name on the schedule.
Are you giving a talk?
No, just passing through.
Oh.
Hey, you know Whit Cobb over at OGC?
Sure, what gives?
Well, we're putting something together. Your name came up. You got a minute?
Yeah.
Here we are. Hey, look who I found.
Hey, Whit. How's it been?
Stuart. Great to see you again after all these years.
And you.
This is Bob.
He's OGA.
Stu and I worked together on... Sit down.
Thank you.
Stu and I worked together on that drug case back in, when was it?
96, 97.
He rolled them up one after another. Leonard called him his dog on a chain.
General Leonard could get us to low crawl through hell in a gasoline suit.
You been paying much attention to what's going on down at Gitmo?
A little, yeah.
I have orders to stand up a 9/11 war court for enemy combatants held in Guantanamo under jurisdiction of the president.
You're familiar with Ex Parte Quirin?
The World War II case with 8 Nazi saboteurs that were caught sneaking into the U.S. by U-boat?
Mm. 8 Nazis? 8 convictions in less than a month.
You forgot the punchline. 6 of them were given the electric chair. Mm. Rough justice, that's what this administration wants. Mm. We've taken a lot of prisoners in Afghanistan, working our way through to Bin Laden and the guys who planned this shit. There's a backlog needs clearing.
Bill tells me a good friend of yours was on one of the planes, 9/11.
Bruce Taylor. He was first officer on Flight 175, the plane that hit the South Tower. We flew KC-130s at Cherry Point together. Kathy and my wife, Kim, they worked in the same hospital together.
Mohamedou Oldslahi, the Mauritanian. Fought with Al-Qaeda in Afghanistan in the 90s. Key recruiter for 9/11 in Germany. He recruited Marwan al-Shehhi, the son of a bitch who flew your friend's plane into the South Tower.
The administration regards this as the first death penalty case. We want you to lead the prosecution.
When we start.
Our flight time is 3.5 hours to Cuba. We offer no beverages, no snacks, and no facilities aboard this aircraft. Thank you.
Naval Base Guantanamo. This base exists outside of U.S. legal jurisdiction. If you stray outside the designated areas, you will be removed from the island. Apart from your client, you're not to speak to or communicate with the detainees. You're not to discuss classified information with your client, even if it pertains to his case. Illegal disclosures may result in your arrest and immediate removal from the island. If you wish to grab your client some grub, do so now.
Do we know what he likes?
Get the fillet of fish, Salau.
Bound.
Defending freedom.
Open up! Sir.
Step up to the line, ID's out. Need your bag here. Glasses off. Take a notepad and one writing implement in with you. It's recommended you wear a hijab when visiting your client. We've had incidents of inmates spitting at female lawyers. Step up to the line, ID's out. Any notes you take here are deemed classified. We'll collect them after your meeting. You can retrieve them in a secure facility stateside.
We are on safety. We will be monitoring the meeting.
You listening to us? You recording?
No. Video only. In the event the detainee lunges for you, push back away from the table. We'll get in there as quick as we can.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam.
Bonjour, enchanté. Je suis Maître Teresa Duncan, et je veux
dire... My lawyers.
You speak English? How did you learn?
Same as you. One word at a time. Sit.
I'm Nancy Hollander. This is my associate, Terry Duncan, and we're from the firm of Friedman, Boyd, and Hollander based in New Mexico, and we wish to represent you.
We brought you some food. Hope it's okay. It's all they have on base.
Mr. Slahi, I understand that it might be hard for you to believe, but that we are not here as interrogators. We are not working for the U.S. government in any way. Well, I'd like to explain your legal situation. In June, the Supreme Court, the highest court in the land, ruled that prisoners in Guantanamo are entitled to file for habeas corpus petitions. This means that the government must produce any evidence that they have against you, and then the court decides if that evidence is enough to justify holding you, and if it isn't, you'll be released. You agree to let us represent you. We will file a writ of habeas on your behalf. Contract.
How can you defend me if you don't even know what I'm charged with?
Have you been charged?
No, no, no. 3 years, they charged me with nothing. They kidnapped me from my home, put me in a jail in Jordan for 5 months, then in a military base in Afghanistan, which was like living in a toilet, by the way, and brought me here with a bag on my head and chains around my body.
What do they accuse you of during your interrogations?
I'm interrogated 18 hours, every day, 3 years. That's like, go ask Charlie Sheen to name all his girlfriends.
So you get the news here.
Now that I cooperate, they let me have a TV. We don't get news, but we have this show, E! Exclamation.
It's just E. I think the exclamation is silent.
Well, have they shown you any evidence that they have against you?
No. Yes. No. Well, one time they showed I had taken a call from Bin Laden's satellite phone.
Did you?
Yes, I did. That was my cousin. He calls me. I don't know what phone he is using. I took a call.
Just the once? He just called you once from Bin Laden's phone?
Yeah. They're watching everything I say, everything I do.
They only have video.
Oh, yeah? We can't talk about these things, not here.
Will you write it down? Your story, how you came here, what happened to you, will you write that down for us?
So my interrogators can read it? I tried that once already. It didn't end well.
Well, we need your testimony.
I've been writing all my life, and I like that, but writing here is way much dangerous than talking.
Well, if you choose to let us represent you, then we will have attorney-client privilege. And that means that anything that you say, anything that you write down, will be protected from the prosecution by law. I can't use it against you. If you don't want to do that, then don't sign. You can stay here trouble-free.
1 minute.
Okay.
You don't want them for me. Call this number. Ask to speak to my mother. Tell her, I don't know, something nice.
That's it.
All right.
See you later, alligators. Now you have to say
After a while, Crocodile.
Not for a while, Crocodile.
Good enough.
Gather your notes together. You'll get them back at the secure facility stateside. In here.
Who decided to put him in shackles?
Protocol. It's for your protection, man.
I want to know whose name I should cite when I contact the National Security Desk at the New York Times. You tell your CO, I don't want to see my client in shackles ever again. Are you praying?
No, memorizing his mother's number.
No, we're not going to call that number. Now we got to clear it first. We don't know who's on the other end of that line.
You don't think it's his mother?
I don't know. But no one just gets a phone call from Bin Laden's sat phone.
This is our guy. He got a scholarship to study electrical engineering in Germany in 1988. 2 years later, he traveled to Afghanistan and joined Al-Qaeda. These are just two of the bad guys we know he associated with. Mahfouz Ould al-Walid, otherwise known as Abu Hafs, Slahi's cousin and brother-in-law. They were close growing up. In the mid-90s, Abu Hafs was designated personal poet and spiritual advisor to Bin Laden himself. Between 97 and 99, German intelligence tracked money transfers and phone calls between Slahi and his cousin in Afghanistan. We can show that Slahi was financing terror. Ramzi bin al-Shib, the so-called 20th hijacker. In 99, Slahi recruited bin al-Shib and other members of the Hamburg cell, including Marwan al-Shehi, pilot of the plane that hit the South Tower, and Ziad Jarrah, who was on United 93. That's just two. There's about 10 other scary names he crossed paths with. This dude is the Al-Qaeda Forrest Gump. Everywhere you look, he's there.
It's all there in the top sheet. Now we gotta check through the intel reports and corroborate. Be exacting, thorough. We are seeking the death penalty, but if we miss something, this guy goes home, all right? Let's get to it.
Please apologize to her. It's just taking a while to get the clearance.
Madam Slahi would like to know, have you really seen her son?
Yes, we've seen him. In Guantanamo prison, Cuba.
Wrap it up. I'll see you afterwards.
Hello, are you there?
Yes, hi, sorry.
How does he look? Is he well? Is he eating?
He looks well. He wanted us to tell you that he misses you very, very much.
We need to go to Virginia. I just got notification from the privilege team. Mohammed has written to us.
Okay. I typed up first that call.
Do you know why Mohammed wanted us to call her?
Because she's his mother.
Because every mother believes that her son is innocent. He wanted us to hear that. That doesn't matter because it's not the case we're building. We need to prove that the U.S. government lacks evidence sufficient to detain him. Anything else is a distraction. Files are in. We need to get to Virginia.
Any material you read here is between you and your client, but anything you want to cite in court or remove from the facility has to be cleared by me or another member of the privilege team.
You have to read it?
Oh yeah, every word. So try and only bring me the juicy stuff. Oh, but don't worry, we're walled off from the prosecution. If we share anything with them, I'm doing prison time. Trust me, I ain't cut out for that. Once we've reviewed the material, we designate it either classified or protected. Protected means you don't have to come in here to view it. We will fax it to your office, where it can only be accessed by those with proper clearance. Anything from here ends up in my Sunday papers. Well, you guys are the lawyers. You know how that goes. Don't lose your keys. It is a pain in the butt to find a locksmith with the proper clearance. That's a joke. You got spares. Don't forget your codes, and my office is down there when you're done.
Wait, we didn't get your name.
Kent.
Kent what?
Kent. Tell you any more than that.
Feels good.
All right, take half.
Where are the case files? Nancy? The government withheld the case files?
Yeah. They're not going to give us anything until they absolutely have to. I already put in for a Freedom of Information request. And until that gets in, just focus on our client's testimony.
Turn around. 760, that's you. I said turn around. Hand on head.
حامد لك مشي ومجية وحامد لك مني العمد علي من كرمك لا تقبلني بيه
Give me your hands.
Turn around. Turn! Turn around!
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam. We're here to have a conversation.
أنا جينا نتحدث.
We want to understand your whole story.
نريد أن نفهم قصتك كاملة.
No one's gonna hurt you.
لا أحد ممكن يتعدى عليك.
That shit is not allowed.
ممنوع.
You have any questions?
أي أسئلة؟
لماذا كوبا؟ أنتم تقرأون كوبا.
Why Cuba? You guys hate Cuba.
Who says we're in Cuba?
من قال لك احنا في كوبا؟
رأيتها بالمطار.
I saw it at the airport.
وصير؟ أننا في كوبا؟
Why is it a secret we're in Cuba?
Not anymore. The idea is to, you know, disorient you. We have a base here. It's secure, it's warm. Plus, I get to surf when I'm off duty.
هذا مناسب للجميع.
It works for everybody.
Exactly. It's like 300 degrees in here. I don't know how you guys want to drink tea. حرارة
800 درجة. لا تشربون شيء.
You married?
متزوج.
أنا مطلق.
Divorced.
وأنت؟
Are you?
Yeah, divorced too.
فأنا مطلق.
Trust me, brother. I know how that goes.
أعرفك شيء.
Let's talk about your family. Your dad's job.
ما عمل أبوك؟
Any travel?
يسافر.
كان يسافر دائما للعمل.
Constantly traveled for work.
كان راعي جمال.
He was a camel herder.
متى؟
He died.
عندما كنت في التاسعة.
When I was 9.
طيلت حياته رفض أن يركب السيارة.
All his life he refused to get in a car.
خاف أن
he felt like it would ruin his natural ability to navigate.
Wait. He never rode in a car.
عمرو.
Yeah, whoa. Like yeah, I'm calling bullshit.
نطمحه. نطمحه.
You're right. I'm lying.
ذات مرة استقل السيارة.
He got in a car once.
لكنه
to look for a lost car.
توقف بعد متراهين.
After 2 seconds, he freaked out and got out.
Full on.
My father's one and only 2 seconds ride. You pried it out of me.
Give me fast forward a bit.
قدم في الكلام.
Afghanistan. How'd you come to train with Al Qaeda?
خبرنا عن تدريبك مع القاعدة.
Kathy.
Hey.
Hey. How are you?
Good. Everything all right? Kim and the boys?
I just didn't want anyone else to tell you, but I'm prosecuting a Gitmo case. One of the recruiters from 9/11.
He put those men on my husband's plane?
I didn't mean to ambush you. I just didn't want somebody else telling you. Kathy, I'm gonna make him pay.
Thank you. You know, Bruce never liked coming to church much. He always said he felt closer to God in the cockpit. Well, if God was on flight 175, he is sure as shit with you right now. Yeah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Turn around. Give me your hands. Move.
تقبل الله. لا تصلي العصر.
اش قضيت لك الصلاه ديالك اصاحبي الا وصلتك لهنا. خماسي نوتيل.
Ah, t'as pas compris. Moi j'ai toujours prié pour voir le monde.
Ici tu dois faire attention à qui tu parles.
Pourquoi t'es un garde?
Je te dirai pas.
Je t'appelle comment?
Les gars, frère. J'ai pas de nom ici. Les gardiens, ils écoutent tout. Appelle-moi par mon numéro, 241.
Non. Je t'appelle pas par un numéro. Tu viens d'où?
France. Marseille.
Marseille. Enchanté, Marseille.
Moi aussi, frère.
C'est comment Marseille? On m'a dit que c'était magnifique.
Ça se voit que tu n'y es jamais allé alors. Tu es un fou, Marseille, c'est un shit hole, frère. Enfin, c'est ce que je pensais jusqu'à ce que j'arrive ici. Et toi, je t'appelle quoi?
Moi, je viens de la Mauritanie.
D'accord. Le Mauritanien.
Ça veut dire quoi, shithole?
Quoi, tu comprends pas l'anglais? Comment tu fais avec les gardiens?
Ouais, le temps que j'apprenne, je serai déjà rentré chez moi.
Peut-être. Peut-être pas. Peut-être. Peut-être que tu vas devoir prier beaucoup plus fort alors.
Yes, I am gonna win this. And I don't take no for an answer.
No, you should.
And I won. You should have seen his face.
I know what you mean. You're always winning. We like it that way, don't we?
Sorry. So yeah.
Now I know you're ignoring me.
Nancy, do you know Jeff and Valerie, General Counsel for Spirit Dynamics?
Oh yes, airplanes and missiles. We need to talk about that Guantanamo case of ours. Shall I just pull up a seat?
If you excuse us for a minute. Please, no. Come on.
All right, I need a favor.
Most people, they say, please, may I? None of this kamikaze bullshit.
But you owe me. All right, I took over the Slahi case. I got his family off your back, which, let's be honest, that's all you were hoping for.
What do you need?
I need to corroborate Slahi's testimony. Right, there was a French national that was detained alongside of him. Guantanamo's pretending he doesn't exist. I don't know his name, but I have his prison ID, which is 241.
What can I do with only a number?
He's from Marseille. So call DGSE, see if they can track him down. All right, it's one phone call, buddy.
Did you see Slahi found himself a lawyer?
Who?
Nancy Hollander. Some humanitarian crusader down in Albuquerque. She's been fighting the government since Vietnam. That's a losing battle.
Sir?
Mm-hmm.
I'm kind of confused. See, there's so many contradictions in these reports.
Yeah, well, that's how it is with raw intel. You gotta order them by date, put all the pieces together.
See, that's just it. JCF interrogators, they left all the dates off. I could put a call in.
Good luck with that. CIA won't help. They're still treating Slahi's intel as active.
Neil Buckland?
Who's that?
A classmate of mine at Quantico. It's his name on the report.
Say, Neil, how's the rental market here? I'm thinking of moving Kim, boys here for the summer. This case keeps dragging out.
Case, you talking about your Gitmo thing? How's that going?
Tell you the truth, I'm lost in the sauce of it. I mean, yeah. Whole thing would move a lot faster if I could get an understanding of how some of these IRs came together.
No way, Jose. Seventh floor's got all that Gitmo intel locked up tight.
Well, your name's all over some of my case files.
You working down there when Slahi came in? Slahi? That's your guy? Oh, my God, you must be feeling it. I hear POTUS tracks him in his daily.
You know anything about him recruiting Ben Elsh yet?
I don't know. Gitmo was churning out MFRs. The whole desk pitched in on it, put the reports together.
MFRs, what's that?
Memorandum for the record. You're working off of summaries. MFRs are the originals and carry all the details. You know, who was there, techniques used, detainee transcripts.
Can you give me access to those?
Sure, if I don't mind violating the Espionage Act. I mean, come on, what do you need them for? You know what they did. The whole world saw it go down on TV.
About your relationship with Osama.
أخبرنا عن علاقتك مع أسامة.
تعرف إني لم أقابل بن لادن.
You realize I've never met bin Laden, don't you?
But your cousin called you from bin Laden's satellite phone.
عم بكلمك من تليفون ساتليت تاع بن لادن.
And just after that phone call, your cousin wired you $5,000 from an Al Qaeda training camp.
مكالمة. ولد عمك صرفت لك $5,000 من مركز تدريب القاعدة.
أنا زوجو خلتي مريض.
My cousin's father in Mauritania was sick.
بحاجة المال للمستشفى.
And he needed the money for the
hospital. لذلك ابنه أرسل للمال.
So his son sent me the money, and I paid the hospital.
You got proof?
عندك شي دليل؟
دليل. أعذرتوني عريان.
No proof. You brought me here naked.
لا أعرف هذا الرجل.
I don't know this man.
Well, he knows you. We captured him in Pakistan. I interrogated him myself. He was very, very cooperative.
Yeah.
I think. قبلته مرة واحدة. مرة واحدة.
I think we met one time.
Yeah, well, wrong again, bro. Ramzi bin al-Sheib says he knows you very well.
His name is Ramzi?
His name is Ramzi?
Come on, man. He was one of the key actors in 9/11. The 20th hijacker. He says he stayed with you in Germany, that you recruited him, and Maran al-Shahi, Ziad Jarrah.
Marwan Shahi, Ziad Jarrah.
No.
He's lying.
Listen, we've got sworn testimony saying that you are the head recruiter for 9/11. Now, if you can't sell me on your version of events, I'm going to have to go with Bin al-Shibs.
No.
He stayed with me only one night.
He
was a friend of a friend of a friend from the mosque. My house was like that. Anyone could come stay.
That's it. Yeah. You're gonna have to do better than that.
اخويا اسمع لي انا حضرت تحقيقات امريكيين بزاف فهمتيني طريقه واحده ان انت تعاون نفسك انت تتكلم فهمتيني الا اريدوا يعرفوا معلومات عن الشخص انت تقول لهم
لا تكون ما اعرف انا اكبر منك انا مش كذاب وانت مش اخي
your hands.
Ça va, Marseille?
Ouais.
J'ai entendu ton numéro hier. Ça dit quoi, alors?
Alors, c'est bon. Ils ont décidé que j'étais innocent. Je rentre chez moi demain.
Ah ouais? Tiens, regarde en haut.
On a entendu ça?
Ah ah. C'est mon interrogatrice. Je vais balancer un nom, frère.
Elle pas faire ça.
Ouais, je sais.
On va le faire souffrir comme nous, maintenant.
Ouais. En même temps, Omar Sharif.
Mais non.
Si, je te jure. Peut-être que c'est pas américain, mais qu'ils connaissent Scotchy, je te jure. Vas-y, lâche le ballon. Vas-y, j'attends.
Ouais, ça va bien.
وصلتنا هذه البروة من مدرستك كاتبين عنك جبرت بورس للمال
والدتي تمالك
الحمد لله قالوا عنك ناجي ما شاء الله يا غير تمشي عنا
يا عتي والدتي ما تبغي نمشي ما نحرك
شنو؟ تبي شنو ولا شنو؟ ما تضيع الفرصة له تمشي حتى فارض عليك تمشي احنا ما عندنا ما وانت
It's a lot of case files.
Well, the government's had a 4-year head start on us. All right.
You guys didn't come see me today. What's the latest from your pen pal?
What, did the printer at the Pentagon have a hissy fit? What the fuck is this, Kent? It's all redacted.
Hey, I'm responsible for what goes out. You get a problem with what comes in, you take it up with the government. God damn it.
Stu.
Sir.
I'm gonna grab some lunch with Whit Cobb tomorrow.
He's going to ask us to set a trial date.
We're not there yet, sir. We're still trying to corroborate.
You got boxes of corroboration. The FBI didn't have this much evidence on Gotti.
Technically, this ain't evidence, sir. It's just hearsay. Summaries. It's like he said this, that, and the other. But we have no idea when he said it or who he said it to. The res gist of it all.
If we don't give the OGC a date, pretty soon they're going to give us one.
Well, looks like we're going to have to find another way to cut the head off this snake.
No. What the hell are you doing running the ball on third and long? Come on, man.
Neil, I think something's burning. I can smell it all the way from the office.
Need a hand?
Go. You're missing the game. Please tell me you didn't drive all the way down here for anything other than football and fellowship.
The White House is breathing down my neck to charge Slahi, and I'm still fumbling around for a light switch.
Well, okay. How about I tell you what? I can swing you an agency liaison for your task force.
They won't have the horsepower.
What are you asking for?
You've been on the inside of these things. How do I get myself the MFRs? The original notes.
You don't, Stu. You don't. Don't lean on me, man. Look, you know that the raw stuff's only for the intel community, not evidence for trial.
Well, that's where this is headed. If I turn up with 20,000 summaries, unless I have one, put it in the bag piece of evidence, Slahi's gonna walk, and I can't have that.
You know who General Mandel is? He oversees the JTF interrogations. He's the only person who can sign off on the MFRs.
So I'm gonna go down to Gitmo.
Yeah. Well, the general's not coming to use for it.
Serious, how do you know this?
Lots of sugar, 6 tablespoons. Your mom was very specific.
You gonna speak with her? What did she say? She's good.
Yeah, she's good. She wanted me to tell you that your brother
Yadi,
you moved back home, and your niece has a daughter. And another little one on the way, and if it's a boy, they're gonna name him after you.
Two children already. MashaAllah.
Your letters have been coming through.
We're good. You checked the seals?
Nothing's been tampered with.
You sure? 100%?
Yes. And you need to keep writing, else your letters are invaluable. Especially now. The government won't show us the evidence they have against you.
Because I have none. You'll see, I keep writing. And, they're good, my letters. And you understand everything.
No, mm-hmm. They're great. You should have been a writer.
Next life, God willing.
No, I mean it. Even the privileged team enjoys reading them.
What? What's privilege?
It's okay. They're separate from the prosecution.
Who is reading? You say to me, attorney client. I am client. You are attorney. What the fuck is privilege team?
It's an independent body. They evaluate your letters and determine what needs to remain classified. But they're walled off from the government and the prosecution.
If my guards read the letters, I am here. It's me they will fuck. Not you.
We can't go forward without the privileged team. Now, that's all there is to it. You gotta trust me. We haven't even gotten in the ring yet. need you to sue the government.
What?
We have to file a motion to compel to get them to release the evidence that they have against you. We can't fight what we don't know.
I mean what I say. There's no evidence. I trust you, you trust me. I am innocent, okay? What do you need to see to believe this?
It doesn't matter what we believe. What matters is what we can prove.
I like my interrogators, just like them.
We know that you're innocent. We do. But we have to prove that, and we can't do that unless we see the allegations against you. That's all we're asking for.
Who do you want to sue? You say government. What does it mean?
There'll be three names on the lawsuit. The United States of America, Donald Rumsfeld, and George W. Bush.
Sorry, sure. Why not?
You know, all he wanted was to hear that we believed he was innocent. Why wouldn't he just say it?
I think I was calculated on the tea. I'm not gonna last 3.5 hours. Want anything?
Nancy Hollander? I'm Stuart Couch, lead counsel for the government in your client's case.
All right.
Just got here. Seeing the camp tomorrow. Can I get you a drink?
Okay.
I wouldn't want to post out here, but the R&R doesn't look so bad.
You know, one day this will all be a tourist attraction. I'm not kidding. And the cruise ships from the Keys will come and dock, and crowds will wander around the cells with their daiquiris, trying to wrap their heads around what the hell happened here.
What do you think is happening here?
I don't know yet, but they built this place out of the reach of the courts for a reason.
The world's second largest minefield to the north and shark-infested waters to the south. There's two reasons.
And what's the reason that you're sitting on the case files?
I'm not. We submitted for discovery months ago.
I received 20,000 pages of redacted materials. So
you should file a motion to compel.
I'm going to.
I won't stand in your way.
You won't stand in my way.
You cranks all think that we're trying to set up some kind of lawless garrison site.
We're drinking beers in a prison gift shop. What the hell else would you call it?
Military's found in law and order. They won't let you out of boot camp unless you can square a 4-inch fold on a bedsheet. The law says you get open file discovery, and I want you to have discovery. That way, when I beat you, your client will have nothing to hide behind.
You sound very sure of that outcome.
You haven't seen what I've seen. Let me ask you, I understand everyone has a right to a defense, but doesn't it bother you at all working for someone like this?
I'm not just defending him, I'm defending the rule of law.
How very Ignatian of you.
I didn't know that they studied the Jesuits in the Marine Law School.
We like to fully consider a problem before we blow it up.
My turn. Let me ask you. What if you're wrong?
We're not.
What if you are? You built this place. You abandoned all of your principles, all of your laws, and you were wrong. change the conversation.
What?
Make this case about Mohammadi, we're gonna lose. Need a new strategy.
Sir.
Colonel, welcome to Camp India. Your man Slahi was on this block for a while.
What do they like to read?
All types of stuff. If it's on there, it's a detainee request.
Bet they love this religious fiction.
They go nuts with that stuff, sir. Look, we like to mess with them. Tear out the last chapter. Not me, sir. Some of the other guys. Got an empty bed on this block if you want to take a peek.
Sure. Whew. Freezing. What temp to keep it at?
AC only go down to about 52.
There are two types of music I can't abide. One is heavy metal, the other is country. At a pinch, I'll suck it up to country.
Colonel, coming through.
General, I notice you keep the tent low and there are restraints in the walls and the floor. What is that, sleep deprivation?
That's one of the tools in the box. Colonel Seidel told me you were a naval aviator. You went through New Brunswick, the Sierra School they run up there.
I did.
I take it you didn't enjoy it.
What's not to enjoy? Three nights in the hole with a bucket to piss in and they pump in chainsaws and crying babies through your speakers 24 hours a day. In training, things get pretty loopy.
You confessed to shooting Kennedy?
No, sir, I did not.
A couple of sleepless nights, that's all. We pull from the same playbook. You and every other Green Marine made it out all right. They will too.
Sir, the defense is going to play every card that they can. If they've got grounds to claim duress, it's better I know about it now. Did the colonel tell you why I wanted to see you?
He did. I told him to save you the trip. He said you wouldn't take no for an answer, but I'm afraid that's the answer I have. I'm enormously proud of what goes on inside JTF, but my hands are tied. I am not at liberty to share MFRs.
Sir, if it is a clearance issue, I am TSSCI.
It's an agency issue.
But I was told specifically by the agency that you're the man to see.
That sounds like something a spook would say, doesn't it?
So, how was your trip?
Not what I expected.
Seven six. Reservation. Seven-60 reservation. Hurry the fuck up.
760 reservation. Hurry the fuck up.
Knock it off. You're not a parrot.
Not a motherfucker parrot.
Come on, man. Get it together. Let's go. Stand up. Turn around. Turn around.
First, you tell me your name.
You know me 1 year, I don't know your name.
I'm not allowed to do that. Turn around.
You're a good soldier. Like G.I. Joe.
Say, c'est toi?
Why?
What you doing, motherfucker?
J'apprends l'anglais avec des bouquins à part avec les gardiens.
D'accord.
Est-ce qu'il va pas?
J'ai reçu une lettre de ma femme.
Mais alors, c'est super, ça. Hein?
C'est une lettre, frère. C'est pas ma femme. T'as une famille, toi? T'as des gosses?
الدكتور قال بأن هالوضعية ممكن تساعد. حبيبي، الدور ولد أو بنت؟
Afghanistan kam es zu einem weiteren Aufflammen der Gewalt zwischen der Regierung und den Kämpfern.
تعرف السوفييت بخطفوا النساء بالهليكوبتر الان
بياخذوهم على قواعدهم يغتصبوهم
اخوات الشعب
لازم نعمل شيء
المسجد بيجمع تبرعات
نقود المتطوعون يقدمون حياتهم
اذا نتخلى عن حياتنا هنا
أي حياة؟ سيارة جديدة وبيت أكبر وأطفال؟
ما هي الحياة؟ لازم تكون أكثر من هيك، لا؟
So you just decided to become a fucking terrorist؟
No. No terrorist. I speak English, maybe. I go to Afghanistan to help Muslims against the communists. Americans fighting with us. Same side.
Same side.
Who recruited you to Al-Qaeda?
Same side. No one, me. You know, listen, same side.
I trained with Al-Qaeda for a few months in 1990 and 92.
Bullshit.
Then I left. That's it.
So why did you delete all the contacts in your cell phone then? When you were arrested, your phone was wiped.
How many times I say? Me no want trouble for a friend.
Oh, because you are so sharp. Oh, yeah, you got an answer for everything. That must be why they gave you that little scholarship, huh?
Hey, Marseille. T'as encore perdu ton ballon.
Garde-le. Il est pour toi. J'en ai plus besoin.
T'es libéré?
Personne sortira d'ici.
Ils peuvent pas nous garder ici toute la vie, tu sais. Ne laisse pas t'enlever ta foi, tu verras. Un jour, tu rentreras chez toi, mon frère. Marseille, c'est au bord de la mer. Hein?
Ouais.
Nouakchott aussi. La première chose que je ferai en rentrant chez moi, c'est m'allonger et écouter le bruit des vagues. Tu les entends, là?
La mer, c'est toujours la même.
Ferme les yeux. Et écoute. Là, tu peux rêver chez toi.
Oui.
C'est pas mort.
C'est mort.
Let's go.
Move. Hey.
Don't drag it. Come on.
See you later, alligator.
Can I get you a water?
I'm fine. Thanks.
Hey, Nancy.
Hollander.
Nancy.
Greg.
You gotta have a seat.
Before we begin, I should warn you, it's not gonna be a puff piece.
Where should we start?
Well,
people have called you a terrorist lawyer. How do you respond to that?
Well, when I defended someone charged with rape, nobody called me a rapist. When I defended someone charged with murder, nobody dug around my backyard. But when someone's accused of terrorism, people like you seem to think that that's different. It's not. When I stand by my client and I insist that he gets a fair hearing, I'm not just defending him, I'm defending you and me. The Constitution doesn't have an asterisk at the end that says, terms and conditions apply.
You see the journal today, sir?
Yeah.
Can't believe she sat down for this. It's a demolition job.
You know, what it is a paradigm shift. Yesterday we were prosecuting a 9/11 terror suspect, and now we're debating the merits of habeas. Where's Arjun?
That is unacceptable. Sir, call her again. No, I don't want to talk to you. I don't want to talk to you. Call her again.
Call her again.
Sir, he's not clear to enter the building.
They pulled my pass.
Just give some
sir, I have to,
just,
I have to insist.
Just a minute. Who's they?
I don't know. Someone revoked my clearance and I have orders to return to Lejeune.
What'd you do?
Nothing. I sent out the information request you asked for.
Who to?
FBI, Langley, Interpol,
sir,
anybody who touched the MFR.
I'm going to have to ask you to leave. You can't be.
I'm going.
So I talked to everyone, the GSE, the ARM, diplomacy. Nobody knows about your guy from Marseille.
Well, maybe he's not a French national. What about Moroccan, Algerian, Tunisian?
No, I thought about that. SIS says all the nationals in Guantanamo are accounted for. There is no record of 241.
Where did he go?
Nancy, maybe he doesn't go anywhere. Maybe he doesn't exist.
Maybe.
Ask you something. My friend, his number is 241. I don't see him for a long time. You know where he is?
I can't talk to you about other detainees, Mo.
What happened to him? Steve, please. He has a wife and children.
241 was found dead in his cell last month.
Dead from what?
Self-asphyxiation. Sorry, bro. I know you were close.
اللهم اغفر للأحياء منا والأموات الحذيرين بيننا والغائبين صغارنا وكبارنا ذكورنا وإناثنا اللهم من أحيينا أحيينا على الإسلام ومن توفيته فتوفاه منا الله أكبر
السلام عليكم
You okay?
The government does not object to the defense's right to disclosure, but clearing classified evidence is an extremely time-consuming process. We simply need more time, Your Honor.
Thank you, Mr. Patton. Ms. Hollander?
If the government has uniquely complicated issues clearing classified evidence, those are issues of its own making, Your Honor. Mr. Salahi has been spirited across borders. He has been interrogated. He has been held against his will for 6 years without a single charge being laid against him. Now, the Supreme Court said it will not tolerate further delay when it ordered these habeas cases to proceed. The government's had plenty of time, Your Honor.
I'm inclined to agree with Ms. Hollander. The government has 10 days to file, or it will find itself back in my courtroom.
Well, you asked for it. Happy reading.
Financing 9/11, to recruiting the hijackers. He fucking wrote a spreadsheet on the inner workings of Al-Qaeda. Why didn't he tell us that he confessed?
That's not the first time in history that clients lie to his lawyers.
Look at this. Look at all of this. Look at this one. He admits to acquiring explosives to blow up LAX. The Millennium Plot?
What's your point?
He's guilty. He's fucking guilty.
Maybe he is. And he still has a right to counsel.
I'm not saying that he doesn't. I'm saying that he helped to kill 3,000 civilians, and we're doing everything we can to get him out.
And we're doing our job.
I did bake sales for his legal fund. That's not a part of my job. My dad told me I'm not welcome home for Thanksgiving this year. That's not a part of my job.
Get out.
What?
You want turkey and pumpkin pie with Mom and Dad and Uncle Joe? Go on, get out. Go home. You can't win a case if you don't believe your own shit.
I'm not trying to leave.
Stop fucking wasting my time. Get out.
It's our goodbye party.
What's going on? America.
Military intelligence thinks we're wasting our time, so they're gonna take over. See if they can't get you to cooperate.
I cooperate. I tell you everything.
Not according to Ramzi bin al-Shib.
Last chance, Mohammedou. 100 times I tell you. He stayed in my house one night. I don't know him. Never knew him.
Next time I hear about him, he's telling you guys crazy lies about me.
Yeah, well, you're tired of saying it. We're tired of hearing it. Military wants a crack at you.
You should know. Once MI takes over, your sessions won't be as friendly.
Why? No tea, no cake.
Good luck, Mom. All I can tell you, be truthful.
Give me your left arm.
Hey. What are you doing? No.
Why are you taking me?
We're staring.
You moved on.
What? Tyra was fun. Now I'm stuck with only you. She doesn't want to be a lawyer no more?
She moved on from your case. So we won the motion to compel, and the government's released all the evidence that they have against you.
Good. That's what we wanted, right?
All the evidence, including your confessions. Why didn't you tell us?
They're nothing. Like fantasy, yeah. None of that happened.
You signed them.
They made me.
They made you as in they coerced you?
What do you think?
I don't know. You tell me. Did they coerce you? But you gotta tell me what happened, Mohamedou.
You asked me to set fire to this place, but I'm still sitting.
Well, then write it down. All right, that's what the pages are for. Write it down. You need to tell me the truth. You need to tell me what happened to you. I can't defend you. Do you understand that?
I don't need to tell you nothing. Whatever I say, it doesn't matter. This fucking island, I'd die here. Outside my family, my brother, their lives go on. Tara's life goes on. But me here, I'm like a statue. Now you will leave too and your life will go on.
What the hell do you know about my life? This is it, this is my life. I spend my time in places like this helping people like you, that's what I do. But don't question my commitment to your case.
The case. You're not committed to me. A person! No. You think I'm guilty, say it. I mean, you believe I did all these things, so why the fuck are you here? Explain to me, really. You give up your life to sit with such an evil guy like me? Explain to me.
Everybody has the right to counsel. You need to tell me the truth. You need to write it down. If you can do that, then I'll be back. And if not, I'll find you another lawyer. I'm ready.
Let's get away from sleigh bells. Let's get away from snow. Let's make or break some Christmas, dear. I know the place to go.
Merry Christmas, Theo.
Merry Christmas, Nancy.
How'd you like to spend Christmas on Christmas Island? How'd you like to spend the holiday away across the sea? How'd you like to spend Christmas on Christmas Island? How'd you like to hang a stocking on a great big coconut
tree? Hi, Stu.
Hey, Hannah. I didn't know you guys were coming.
Clearly didn't. The I-83 was closed all the way north of Baltimore.
I'm so glad you made it in one piece.
Well, Neil was driving like he was back at flight school the way he was hitting those country roads.
Where is Neil?
He's around here somewhere.
I'll go and find him. You look great, by the way.
He doesn't even say that to me.
Oh, I do.
How's it going, Stu?
Glad I run into you. Been a fruitless endeavor trying to get through to your office.
Well, what can I say? It's been busy.
Well, I went down to Gitmo. Just like you said, I didn't like what I saw. The general's just about the same closed door as you.
Come on, man. It's a party. Enjoy yourself.
Why are you jerking me around? I know it was your people took Arjun off the task force. You know, I've never been part of a conspiracy, but I'm starting to think that this is what it must feel like to be on the outside of one.
I'm sorry, what exactly are you accusing me of?
Hell, I don't even know, because no one is telling me anything. Without those MFRs, my case is a bust.
You're overthinking this, sport. Either wear the jersey or get off the field.
My charge is to get Slahi the needle. No one else is gonna walk in there. Not you, not POTUS. That's on me. And if I'm wrong, when it comes to my reckoning, I'm the one that'll have to answer for it.
And who's gonna answer for Bruce?
You gonna bring his name
into
this?
No, you don't know what we know. United Flight 175, based on evidence gathered from the wreckage, the first thing those terrorists did was slash up a flight attendant to elicit the co-pilot, Bruce, to open the cockpit door and come to her rescue. And then they slit his throat with the box cutter and let him bleed to death on the flight deck as the plane hit the tower. Now someone has to answer for that.
Someone. Not just anyone. Happy fucking holiday.
You killed him, Mom. What does it feel like to have the blood of 3,000 innocent lives all over your hands?
Welcome back to E! News. You know, the buzz surrounding the new 90210 isn't just about the cobbler at the Peach Pit.
Very true. There has been a skinny scandal brewing for a while, and now one of the show's stars is speaking out about her body.
The week Slahi was handed over to military intelligence, we received sign-off from Donald Rumsfeld authorizing the use of special measures.
And you just went along with it?
Yes, I did. We were trying to prevent a second 9/11.
That's Bob. He works here. He can take you to read the MFRs.
Here, sir.
We're gonna break you, scumbag!
What are you doing down there, buddy? Get up! Get the fuck up! Are you praying? I want you to fuck me. Do you hear me? Fucking look at me! I know you want me. I know you want me. You're gonna fuck me.
Since you refuse to cooperate, the U.S. government is authorized to arrest your mother and bring her to this facility. And you can save her. But you need to decide. Do you want to be a defendant or a witness?
I can't be a witness. I can't be a witness.
Are you expecting someone?
I don't know.
Maybe it's your friend. Go answer it.
باكر للعمال بيت بيت.
That's it. That's what happened.
أصحابك؟ There's been confusion.
بقيت الصراحة كلمنا لما وقت تأخر من الليل. حمد مرة كان متحمس. واللي دخلني التنظيم. دونو. يجمع تحت 11 سبتمبر. Kind of a guy.
That's not true. That's not true.
No.
What?
Hey, Mohamedou, have some cake.
I'm not hungry.
Eat when I tell you to. One, eat when I tell you to. Two, eat when I tell you to. Three, eat when I tell you to.
You eat when I say you eat! You shit when I say you shit! You understand me? Don't fucking get down on me, asshole!
Indeed. يا حمد كل شيء فيك مية
You know, if you talk, I can help you get out of here.
How many days? I have been special projects.
No, not days. You've been here months. We need this to stop. You need to tell us what you know. Please. Wait, what are you doing?
You're gone, motherfucker!
What are you doing? This is not sending! What the fuck are you doing?
Get him out of here!
Stop it!
Your mother has been detained, Mohamedou. You see this letter? This is from the Department of Defense. Her transfer to Guantanamo has been approved. I gotta tell you, I have concerns about her safety in this all-male environment. This is your last chance.
You tell Captain Collins. I would like to confess.
Hey, you okay?
How soon can you clear these pages?
What is that, Mo? What's the news from Cuba?
Look, these pages, they put my client in a really vulnerable position. So they need to be handled with sensitivity.
Civilized conversations. I'm very happy with your cooperation, Mohamedou. But I think you've only provided 85% of what you know. I'm sure you'll provide us with the rest.
Yes. Yes, of course. Sleep.
Yeah. You can sleep now.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Will you persevere in resisting evil? And whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord.
I will, with God's help.
Will you do everything in your power to seek justice on earth and treat every human being with inherent human dignity?
Sir?
Is this an inside in the warm issue or a standing out in the cold issue?
We can't prosecute Slahi. We don't have the evidence.
You have multiple signed confessions. What more could you need?
It was given under duress. Fruit from the poisonous tree. He spent 70 days in special projects, tortured. Not a single word he said is admissible.
No, that's what they're trained to say. AQ laid it all out in the Manchester protocols. The second you're detained, claim torture.
This didn't come from AQ, sir. This is coming from our side. Now, I read the MFRs. This guy, Captain Collins, some Navy reservist, he ran the program. Sleep deprivation, waterboarding, stress position, flat-out assault. He specifically threatened to have Slahi's mother shipped to Gitmo to have her raped by other detainees. And it is all documented. It's systemic. OSD approved. Donald Rumsfeld signed the top sheet. What's been done here is reprehensible.
I don't want to hear another word about detainee treatment. Your job is to bring charges. Let a judge decide what's admissible.
Sir, I refuse to prosecute this case. As a Christian, as a lawyer...
What makes you think you're any better than the rest of us?
I don't think I'm better than anybody else. That is the point. Now, we all took an oath to support and defend the Constitution. At the very least, we are miles away from that.
You're a traitor.
What?
I reviewed your correspondence, and I think there are strong grounds for making the government's evidence against you inadmissible.
And you're still my lawyer.
Very much so. I'd like you to consider releasing your letters.
To a newspaper?
Maybe a book. People need to read your story for themselves. And it'll put pressure on the government to give us a court date.
I'm right here for that.
Would you like me to step outside?
Yeah. Keep going.
You don't want to pray?
Are you religious now? Why do you care?
I don't. I care about you.
What do you want me to sign, Nancy? Who am I suing today? God?
No one today.
Then why are you here?
No reason in particular. I just didn't want you to be alone.
Sir?
Sir.
Thanks for schlepping all the way out here.
No problem. Not really that much of a welcome presence anywhere inside of the Beltway, so. Can I get one of them?
I wanted to thank you. You did the right thing.
Yeah, well, my Christmas list just got a little shorter, that's for sure.
Can't be any shorter than mine.
Look, God pays for what he orders, one way or another. He'll make it work.
Here you go, sir.
You really believe that?
I do.
You know, I think I figured out why they built the camp down there. And we were both wrong. It's not the detainees they were trying to keep out of the courts. It's the jailers. My client, he's not a suspect. He's a witness.
Did you ever open up Faction Return Box 32? It's just labeled translations, but look inside. I think you might like what you see.
Box 32.
When's the court date?
Couple of weeks. Mm.
Judge Robertson, he's a tough judge.
Sure is.
Vince him, you've convinced me. Don't get me wrong. If there's any untainted evidence that Slaw he's guilty, I'll stick the needle in his arm myself.
I'd expect nothing less.
The lie detector even once.
Won't stand up in court, but
yeah,
it's nice to know. Box 32, we missed it. Who's that?
It's Marseille. His real name is Amin Jabbar. The IRC helped me find his wife, Samia.
Widow. Wait, where are you going? Come on in. Close the door. We got a lot of work to do.
Nancy Hollander and Teresa Duncan with the ACLU represent the petitioner. Joseph Folio and Robert Patton represent the respondent.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning to Guantanamo.
We've had some preliminary discussion of the procedures we'll follow today. Does the petitioner have any questions?
What? He's asking me? I am the petitioner?
Yeah, you.
What's he saying? I can't hear him. Just can you open that line a little wider?
Why can't they hear me? It all works here.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we're getting that now, yeah.
You can hear me now?
We can all hear you, Mohamedou.
Are you certain, Nancy?
Yes, don't worry. Everyone can hear you.
Is the detainee going to testify? He understands. He doesn't have to, yes?
Yes, Your Honor. He wishes to testify. He knows that he is fighting for his life, and he has nothing to hide.
Mr. Slahi.
Would you please raise your right hand and repeat after me?
I?
State your name.
State your name?
Say your name.
Mohamedou Ould Slahi.
I solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
I solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Go ahead, detainee.
Thank you, Your Honor. Where I'm from, we know not to trust the police. We know the law is corrupt, and we know the government using fear to control us. And when I moved to Germany as a teenager, for the first time I experienced living where people do not fear the police, where they believe the law protects them. For me and for so many people in the world, America is like this. Even in Mauritania, we have watched Law and Order and Ali McBeal. And when I first arrived at Guantanamo, I'm happy because I trusted in American justice. Never did I believe I would be 8 years a prisoner without trial, and that the United States of America would use fear and terror to control me. All my time here, I've been told, you are guilty. You are guilty. Not for something that I have done or that has been proved, but because of suspicions and associations. If you have a problem with the United States of America, you will have that problem forever. My captors cannot forgive me for something that I have never done. But I am trying to forgive. I want to forgive. Because that is what Allah, my God, wants. For this reason, I do not hold a grudge against those who abused me. You know. In Arabic, the word for free and the word for forgiveness is the same word. This is how, even here, I can be free. For 8 years, I have been dreaming of being in a courtroom, and now that I'm here, really, I'm scared to death, but, but I hope I can find peace. Because I believe this court is guided by law, not fear. So, whatever you decide, Your Honor, I can accept it. May God forgive us, and may God be with us.
hurt me?
Mail for 760.
Guys, I won.
What?
What?
I won my case.
It's written here.
I'm going home.
Good, man. Yeah, man.
Fuck. Going home, freedom!
Seven-sixty.
Are you ready?
Turn around.
Here we go.
Something made for them locally to engrave their names in Arabic. something very symbolic, but something that doesn't wear away, just like our friendship wouldn't wear away.
Thank you.
This is my book. Das Guantanamo Tagebuch. This is French.
Yes.
This is Günlü. This is Turkish. Endagbok. Guantanamo Endagbok. I don't know what language this is, but I would say this is Swedish. This is Danish. This is Italian. Oh, they really did a very good job in hiding a lot. Oh, look at here. Look. Bob Dylan song. As for compensation, there's a little hidden. Women like you, the truth, the man in me. Aging all around my door. That's exactly like me. I cannot take it anymore. Well, I do. The man in me. What a wonderful feeling.
Just to know that you are near. It sets my heart a reeling from my toes up to my ears. The man in me will hide sometimes to keep from being seen, but that's just because he doesn't want to turn into some machine. Take a woman like you to get through